You're watching UNICEF television. Blowing the whistle against polio. It could be the final countdown for these feisty young frontline workers in the battle to rid India of the crippling disease. Dashing house to house, whistling and rallying the troops of mothers of babies to come and get their drops, the children of Moradabad in Uttar Pradesh, India, search high and low for any child who might have missed out on the magical drops that saves lives and limbs here. It's all part of a vibrant community effort against polio. This was once the very epicenter of the polio epidemic, with the highest polio cases in the world. Just 2 years ago, there were 741 polio cases in India. Now, with just one case reported in January this year, there's a real sense that India may soon be declared polio-free. It's mass mobilization campaigns like this that have helped put a stop to the spread of polio. In Uttar Pradesh alone, one of India's poorest states, there are more than 250,000 polio workers signed up, and some of the most effective are those living with the effects themselves. In an environment with huge sanitation and health challenges, this is also about injecting other life-saving messages into the community to boost child survival.
Besides talking about polio eradication, we talk to families about hygiene and sanitation. We tell pregnant mothers that it is best they have institutional deliveries. Within the first hour of the baby being born, mothers should feed the child colostrum and continue exclusive breastfeeding of the children for a minimum of 6 months.
A call to prayer has also been a call to health, and getting the blessing from imams and other religious leaders has been critical in conquering community resistance here.
Initially, we faced a lot of problems. People fought with us, and many a times when they saw polio workers, they would send their children to their family members in different towns or would hide their children, fearing that we would make their children impotent. We instead got doctors and community elders to speak to them and convince them that the vaccine is good for their children and for our nation.
Today, resistance is so rare, it causes a ruckus, like when this woman who feared the vaccines would cause sterility in her son. She too was soon persuaded, and the baby boy was immunized. The one open wound now is tackling those on the move, and in a country with 1.2 billion people, migrant populations leading nomadic lifestyles are hard to track, hard to get on board. That's why bustling transit points like trains and bus stations are the target. The rainy season is the real danger time for the spread of the virus too.
India is historically close to achieving polio eradication. Currently we only have one case for 2011. And the virus in this child did not come from nearby Murshidabad, but actually travelled from Delhi. We know this from environmental sampling that we do. And it's just a perfect example to us really of what a threat the migratory populations pose to us at this stage as we get very, very close to achieving eradication in India.
So today India, tomorrow the world. But to make polio history, it has to be wiped out everywhere once and for all. And the momentum to reach all children here certainly seems unstoppable. This is Sarah Crowe in Moradabad, India. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for children.